In today's video, we're going to talk about 5 new cool features in the new DaVinci Resolve 17. Feature number 1 is the Magic Mask. Basically, Magic Mask is a Roto Brush from After Effects. However, if you use After Effects, you know how terrible that Roto Brush really is. Once you start tracking forward, it slides, it's basically going out of control, and you constantly have to go ahead and fix it. This new Roto Brush, or Magic Mask, I should say, in DaVinci Resolve 17 is excellent, considering this version 17 right now, it's still in the beta. So hopefully they're going to work on it and improve it further down the line. However, from what I can tell you right now, from playing around with the software for a little bit, it works in a very, very excellent way. So I'll definitely be using it. And to me, this is number 1 feature in DaVinci Resolve 17. The second feature that I find really cool in this new release is the Color Warper tool. Basically, in a way, it's the same tool, kind of like a hue versus hue or hue versus saturation. However, it's a little bit more refined way and you have slightly more control of your image. You can do different grids and you can more precisely adjust your image. So this is definitely an incredible tool, especially if you want to be dialing a very creative look. Feature number 3 is HDR Color Wheels. You don't need to be grading in HDR in order to use those color wheels. So basically, what's the whole fuss about? Those wheels are just, in a way, kind of like a log wheels, just a little bit more precise. So you can do a more finesse adjustment. For example, if something clipping in your image, you can adjust it with a more finesse. For example, you can increase or decrease saturation, or you can increase or decrease luma value of that parameter. And basically you can manually set the boundaries and have a little bit more control of your image. For example, if something clipping or slightly clipping, like the bright skies in the background, or you have a slight little bit specular in your image, now you can use those HDR tools to dial it up or down. So I think it's a really cool addition to the whole color page. I've been always advocate for using false colors in DaVinci Resolve, and now finally they have dedicated plugin. So basically, what is a false color? A false color is a visual representation where your exposure is. It's just a little bit easier for those people who are having hard times looking at the waveform, or for example RGB parade, to really judge their shots, like if one shot brighter, if another shot darker. With a false color, you just visually see your exposure representation based on the color. And the cool thing about it, you can modify and basically set your own parameters for your false color. So matching shots with the false colors make it even easier with this new release 17. And finally, number 5 for me is collaboration. It's a very incredible tool, allowing people, especially in a larger projects, to pitch in all together in the same project and give each other feedback as they go. So for example, the editor can talk to the colorist can talk to a sound person, and etc. So I think it's a really cool feature, especially now that DaVinci Resolve allows collaboration to be used in the free version and in the studio version. And if you'd like to know more about how collaboration works, tomorrow I'm going to be dropping a free video from my Insider Knowledge course, how to use collaboration using Frame.io inside DaVinci Resolve. So thank you guys for watching. Be sure to subscribe and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.